Hello, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we start a new tutorial in where I will explain you how to train a large LLM to do document classification. To do this, I choose a novel architecture. The name is T5, which is essentially a variant of transformers. Which is designed by Google and is a special architecture which is trying to solve multiple downstream tasks, and all of them are done with the same model on the same way, using the same loss function and using the same parameters. This hits a common framework in where you just input some text to the model, and you are going to and the model is going to output some text, and it will be prepared to solve a number of tasks for what the model is being trained. This task can be translation, can be classification, summarization, sentence similarity, grammaticality, acceptability, and more. No? So the architecture con the model con in different size from the millions of parameters to 11 billions. This is the size that originally Google were choosing from, well, models with more performance are solving a bigger number of the activities to the biggest one, which how to say, solve a big number of activities, but still keep a reasonable size in comparison with others like Bloom, that has, for example, 300 billions of parameters. After that, the model, all those models was trained with C4 dataset, and after that there were some refinements of the model with different dataset, and finally the model that we are going to use is this one, the FLAN T5, which is a variant of the T5 but trained with the FLAN dataset, which is itself, the FLAN dataset is a number of 62 different datasets that are prepared to solve different downstream activities like natural language inference, common sense, translation, summarization, well, sentimental analysis, and more. Q&A, o sea, question and answer, and more. Okay. So, you had some links here where you can, later I will post the link to this notebook, and you can follow the details in all you want to go deep into the technical details of the model and how they were trained. You can go to these models and URLs and papers, and I strongly recommend you to read the article from Cameron Wolf. It is explaining very concise and clearly how this text-to-text transformer architecture works. By the way, the T5, essentially you can state it here, is referred to the how they name the architecture is text-to-text transformer. So for this initial explanation, for this initial POC, we are going to use a small data set to fine tune the model for to classify documents according to 10 classes. This data set is 1000 documents divided in 10 classes that you can observe here: business, entertainment, food. Every class had 100 documents. It's a small data set, But well, for the purpose of what we are going to do is enough. Later on, the purpose of the project is finally fine-tune the model versus these classes. These classes are defined by Microsoft in a tool, PureView, which is a data governance tool, and then on that is the tools that we will finally use to fine-tune the model. But for this small POC and for this tutorial, we first of all will use this just to show how the architecture works and how to do an initial fine-tuning and to understand if the model is able to generalize and classify correctly only distinct classes. And then on, as you can see as well, today I'm working in Kaggle. Kaggle is a web or another place where you can use as well notebooks and provided with some acceleration with GPUs or TPUs. It's free. You use it for personal use, so for this experiment you can use either Google Colabs or Kaggle, which also will work for this kind of experiments. No? As we did in Colab, you can install what you need. Everything is practically pre-installed. The only thing that I think we miss is 1 dB. And then on, well, the in terms of how it works is pretty similar to Google Colab. It had some folders for inputting data, some other folders to output data. So here in this folder in Kaggle that input, I already placed the dataset, which is I pre-process already all the documents we had here. I put the content of every folder files into a data frame, and this is what we had here in this documents raw.cv. So and I already put it on the Kaggle.input folder, which is usually the folder where you can download either dataset that are available in Kaggle or file that you can upload using this this icon here. Later we create the dataset, the Hugging Face dataset. Oops, something wrong here. Technology.9. Yeah, sorry. Well, similar to in other, we define a dictionary with the categories and labels, a class labeled object with the number of classes and the labels. We read the file, and we map. We are all interested in the attributes, the class and document, and we create a second label, I name it label 2, and just we do a mapping of the classes, the of the categories to numbers. You can see here, I will execute here again. You can see here what we had, pretty similar. Now we create a list per class, per attribute, just to later on create the Hugging Face dataset. With the stratify column name, we use this to ensure is the if you are familiar with scikit-learn, with the train test split in scikit-learn, you had the attribute stratify, which allow your to you ensure that you had the same number of examples per class in train and test datasets. So here in Hugging Face we just choose an attribute that we will use to balance the classes in both datasets, and then on calling the method class encode column, and before doing the split, you will ensure that you had a balance number of the cases or examples of each class in train and test dataset. So essentially here we take we define the dictionary which contain the data, which later on we apply to mapping, and we define the feature text that is a string label to an integer, and the label which is an string as well. We shuffle the data set, we stratify the data set, we do a train split 30% for testing, and we cast the label to which is an integer to the class label object, to the class label class. So dataset, you see here we had 1,700 for training, 300 for testing. So we import the libraries we need. This is an example of train. We just define our tags here. We get the secrets here. Secrets was pretty similar to Google. You just define your secrets, and then on here you have even a code snippet how to use it in the library. We log in Kaggle. We log in 1DB, and we push the dataset to the experiment. Here we just log in, we use the 1DB key we get from the secrets, and we do an init, and we are logging here using the class table, the training dataset and the test dataset, just for later use or for keeping track. No? Okay. Now we just look at the number of labels and counts per classes. Sometimes okay, still uploading the data sets. Okay, that's done. Okay, 10 classes, test dataset. Again, we had a small number, but we'll see how it works. Now we are going to concatenate train and test. We just see what we have, and we load the metric to evaluate the training, and now we will do. We will tokenize the attributes test and label. I will show you now what exactly means that. No? So now here we are downloading the model to this tokenizer. Tokenizer is a feature extractor. It's just transforming the thing into tokens. And also the labels are transformed into tokens. So I use here AutoTokenizer. AutoTokenizer is a generic class that can be used with all models that are available in Hugging Face, and then on using the generic class you don't need to care which model you define to do the tokenization. It will just adjust the load of the model to your specific metadata in the model. So from this initial state, we don't need to care about the specific classes of the defined, we just simply use the generic one. No? And then here we are going to tokenize the text attributes. You will see now what we are doing here. Okay, you just see here tokenized input. So you have the text, and then on if you look at the what we have in the input IDs, we are just doing tokenization. Every work or token in the token, better say token, is translated to an integer, which represent this word or this token into the dictionary of tokens. So this is essentially what is doing the tokenizer. So if you want, I want to see here the length of this tokenizer, of this transformation within, in the case of the example number one is 106. Later I will explain you why you need to care about this. So we do the same for the labels. So this is one of the labels, one of the classes, and then on we are doing the same. No? Here, you see here that you had an inputs, inputs underscore IDs, which is a list of the integers, and then you had another which is attention max, which is essentially telling you that you need to when in attention max you have two options, one or zero, and as you can imagine this means that you need to worry about both tokens. I will explain you this a little bit more in detail now. So here we are doing tokenization of the labels, and here what we are doing is just taking the max length of all the text in the dataset, and also here all the labels in the dataset. Why this is important? Because the input of the model had to be you need to decide. You need to know what is the maximum length of your text, and then on take a decision how many tokens you want to input to your dataset. There is a maximum of 5,096 tokens. So in this case, as the maximum length is of our input. The input text is 512. We will pad all those that are below 512 tokens to 512. So all the inputs have to have the same input, the same length, and all the targets have to have the same length. So what we are going to do is pad all the with a constant, which in this case will be zero, all the input text to 512, and all the input labels to 3, which is the maximum number of tokens in the label class. So here you can see how it looks like the labels. Here we just define the folder where we are going to do the labels, the login. Here we define the arguments for training a text-to-text transformer. We have a specific classes, which are the sequence-to-sequence. Variants of the generic ones, so they are working pretty similar in terms of the parameters, but They are specifically designed to work with sequence-to-sequence models or text-to-text models like T5. No, BERT, for example, is another model that you will use with this class. Output directory for the model checkpoint, number of the elements in per batch, floating point 16 false. Here we will use 32 bits, learning rate, number of epochs, where we are going to lock the locks of the model. Every epoch we do the login in the folder. We don't do, in this case, evaluation per epoch. We say the models per epoch, total number of 2. We download the best model at the end. We report to 1DB. We don't push the model to Hugging Face, so this those of them doesn't apply. And even here, that we are getting the token, as we are not pushing to Hugging Face, they don't apply. We create some helpers functions, that is to pre-process the every input. Essentially, we are tokenizing. And for labels, we don't want to be affected in the loss calculation by these tokens that we use to do padding. You remember the max number of tokens in labels were 3, and then on if we let the padding token, we allowed to use the padding token during the loss calculation, we had the calculations will be incorrect. So what we are doing here is introduce replacing the padding token with a minus 100 in order not to to calculate incorrectly the loss during training. So here as well, we are just creating some helpers to later on calculate the metrics. The metrics that we will use in this case is ROC, LSAM, which is a special metric to which is designed to specifically for translation, mainly for translation activities, but in this case also we can use it for the classification one, and it's pretty similar to the precision metric. So we run this key, we tokenize the datasets, this is the keys that had our tokenized dataset, inputs, attention max and labels. You can see here now that the tokenizer had after padding, this is the token which is telling us that here finish the text, and the padding is zeros, as you can see. And now this, you remember, this is the example number one, and as you can see here, the length of the input is 512. If you look at the masking, the max attention max, we had once up to the moment that start zeros. This is telling the neural network or the transformer which token he should take into consideration at training time. Now we prepare our dictionaries for transform labels into categories and vice versa. We load the model the same that in other tutorials. We take the model, we use here the specific auto model for sequence to sequence models. Auto model as well will allow us to, well, don't use the specific class for the t-files. It's a generic one which works with all the sequence to sequence models in transformers which follow this interface. We download the model. As well, we have a data collator for sequence to sequence model. We load it. They are specifically designed for this kind of models. A sequence to sequence trainer as well. Sorry, here this didn't execute. Okay. Tokenizer text, we clean our GPU and we start the training. So this is going to take 30 minutes. I will be back when this is done. Hi again, the process is done. I wanted to tell you before continue some detail. We are using T5 Flantified base, no, which has a size of 250 million of parameters. This model had a performance similar or even superior or higher to GPT-3. GPT-3 has roundabout, let me get the data, 175 billion of parameters. And then what I want to say with this, when you choose a model to do an activity, you have to take probably many things into consideration. One of them is the budget you have to train a model or to personalize a model for your for the requirement you have in your project. And then going to models or using models like Bloom or like OpenAI models or similar to them. Yeah, they are pretty good models. They are fantastic models, but you need millions of dollars to fine tune, to pre-train these models. No, choosing models with this size, you can be working on very cheap hardware, and even in free use notebook or places like Kaggle or Google Colab, where they are offering accelerators for free. And then it's a matter many times, or it's a trade-off in between the budget and the final objectives that you are gonna get or you want to get, and choosing the model and looking at the details, you can save a lot of money, and secondly you can get the same or even better outcomes than using our well-known models that in many cases only are affordable for big companies, not for conventional researchers or companies which have a limited budget for this kind of activities. So when you try to decide which technologies to use to solve a problem, try to be a scientist and try think what you want to do, how you want to do it, and get as much as information as possible to solve efficiently your problem, and especially on budget, because again you can get the same outcomes spending millions than spending even $0 like I'm doing here, no? Thank you. Okay, so we look at the train results. Now we are going to create a folder for serialize the model, and we will upload the model to 1DB just to have a version of this model for future use. Again, this is not going to be for sure the final model, it's just a small POC to show you how it works. We will be doing on posterior parts of this tutorial how to create a model with more data, with documents which are tailored to the problem that we want to solve with the pure view classes, how to how to download all these files from internet in an efficient way, create the data set, train the model with this data set, do some cleaning, etc. But this for the purpose of this initial part of the tutorial is fine, no? But just I show you how to upload the version of the model to 1DB. We save the model to this folder, and the tokenizer is not personalized, we just use the original FlanTV one, so we don't save it. So if you plan to push your model to Hugging Face, you just need to uncomment these lines, and now we are going to evaluate the model. Here, as you can see, I'm using the specific classes from T5 models, T5 tokenizer and T5 for conditional generation. If you remember about, we use the generic one. These are the ones which are designed to work with the T5 model. Exactly, you call them exactly the same. You load the prompt pre-trained from the folder, and also here from the custom path with custom path, which is the path where we save the model after training. We create a couple of helpers to classify and evaluate the model. We call evaluate model. We are just using the same test data set as used in training. This is not very well as very good test, but we don't have much data, so it's just preparing all the helpers and functions that we will use later on in the final process. Obviously, this data was seen during the training. This is not representative, and now I just took an example that I copy from a newspaper here in UK, Daily Telegraph. I don't remember from. And just I create a helper how to process the text the same way that I did it from with the documents for the original dataset. I pass the test to this and I classified. Obviously it's politics. You read the text, it's politics. Okay, that's all. See you in the next part of this tutorial, which we will do. We will find documents in internet and how to prepare the final dataset with these 56 different classes. And okay, thanks for watching this video. And if you like the content, please give me a like and subscribe to the channel. See you soon.